When you hear the word leech, your mind probably thinks of a creepy, blood-sucking parasite. And while that may be true a lot of the time, leeches are an incredibly diverse group of worms, and not all of them are blood-sucking parasites. Leeches, scientifically known as Hirudinea, are segmented worms, part of a larger group called annelids, which also includes earthworms. There are over 700 known species, and they thrive in freshwater, marine, and terrestrial environments across the globe. While a significant amount of leech biodiversity is made up of parasitic leeches, there are also many predatory leeches that hunt and consume small invertebrates. Leeches have a flattened, bilaterally symmetrical, and muscular body, often in shades of black or brown, though some species boast vibrant colors and intricate speckled or striped patterns. Some leeches are long and worm-like, while others are pear-shaped and broad. Most can vary considerably in shape between their elongated and contracted state and between their starved and full condition. Their body is incredibly flexible, allowing them to expand and contract dramatically. Each segment of their body is further divided into ring-like structures called annuli, which contribute to their flexibility. Most leeches have a suction cup-like mouthpart, often called a sucker, and another similar structure on the posterior end for adhesive purposes. These suckers are essential for their unique locomotion, enabling them to move with an elegant, looping motion, much like an inchworm. The mouth sucker is typically located at the more tapered end of their body. The posterior sucker is attached to a substrate, and the leech stretches out and then attaches to the substrate with the mouth or anterior sucker. The posterior sucker is then detached and pulled up to the anterior sucker. Some leeches also move by undulating swimming motions. Parasitic leeches usually have three jaws and make a Y-shaped incision. All leeches produce mucus from mucus glands distributed throughout the body, and the mucus is important in a number of biological functions, including the prevention of desiccation. Terrestrial leeches have the highest risk of desiccation, so they tend to produce more mucus. In dry weather, some species burrow into the soil where they can survive for many months. The size of leeches can vary significantly, from a fraction of an inch to around 18 inches long. Respiration takes place through their body wall. Sensory organs on the head and body surface enable a leech to detect changes in light intensity, temperature, and vibration. Chemical receptors on the head provide a sense of smell, and there may be one or more pairs of eyes. Leeches are incredibly adaptable creatures. They are most abundant in the warm, calm, and shallow waters of ponds and lakes, often hiding among dense vegetation or under submerged debris to avoid light. Some prefer the mucky bottoms, while others gracefully loop among plants in gently flowing streams. They also thrive in the warm, damp conditions of tropical rainforests. They can even live in extreme environments. Leeches have been found surviving in conditions with drastic variations in temperature, moisture, salinity, pressure, light, and even pollution. They have even been found living deep within cave systems around the world. Parasitic leeches attach to a variety of hosts, such as mammals, reptiles, birds, amphibians, fish, and even snails, in order to consume blood. Blood-sucking leeches can ingest several times their own weight in blood. They secrete a powerful anesthetic that prevents the host from feeling the bite, along with an anticoagulant, which keeps the blood flowing freely. Some leeches attach internally when people drink contaminated water. Compared to terrestrial and freshwater leeches, little is known about the biology of marine leeches. Likely due to the inaccessibility of their primary hosts, such as sea turtles, stingrays, and other fish. Nevertheless, marine leeches can be found worldwide throughout the ocean. Leeches are hermaphrodites, meaning that each individual possesses both male and female reproductive organs. Typically, during mating, two leeches fertilize each other, and as a result, both individuals will go on to produce eggs. Most leech species do not provide extended care for their young. Leeches have a specialized glandular segment called the clitellum. This structure becomes more noticeable during reproduction, as it secretes a protective, ring-like mucus cocoon into which eggs are deposited, safeguarding the developing embryos. A nutrient fluid is provided inside the cocoon for the developing eggs and young. The nutrients typically last until the developing young are large enough to emerge from the cocoon to fend for themselves. The cocoon may be buried or attached to a rock, log, or leaf. After several weeks or months, the young emerge as miniature adults. Fish, birds, turtles, and invertebrates are the main predators of leeches. Beyond their ecological roles, leeches have a long and storied history in human medicine. Dating back to 1500 BC, leeches were employed for bloodletting to treat various ailments. Today, their medical contributions continue, especially in reconstructive surgery. The potent anticoagulants in leech saliva are invaluable for promoting blood flow in reattached body parts, preventing blood clots, and aiding in tissue regeneration. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button.